morning. Amen. When I was a little girl, I loved to go to the beach with my family. We would get to the beach, and I remember so well, we had this huge red umbrella that we drilled down in the sand. We'd put our beach blanket out, get our ice chest, get our spot ready for a day at the beach. And as soon as it was set, I'd take off to the water. I could spend hours out in the waves just having such a good time. And one day, I had been out there, seems like for several hours. In fact, I had made it to the second sandbar. Now, if you know what those sandbars are, they're deep spots, and then you get on the sandbar, and it's like you're on the shore. You can be way out, and you can be just up to your knees. So I had made my way all the way out to the second sandbar. I wanted my family to see me from shore, because I thought, I am really done well today. So I stood up, and I began to wave my hands looking for my family. I was searching everywhere for where our spot was, where we had set that red umbrella. When I realized I could see a lot of people, I could see a lot of things, but I couldn't spot my family. Well, I got kind of panicking as a little girl. I thought, I gotta find my family. Where did they go? So I swam as quick as I could, worked really hard to make it to shore, looking for my family. I walked to the left all the way as far as I could, couldn't find them, turned around, walked to the right, looking and looking for my family. When at a distance, I spotted that red umbrella. And can I tell you, as a little girl, that was a happy moment for me. I thought, there they are, I'm safe and everything is okay. You see, what I didn't realize was when I was out in that water, those undercurrents were slowly taking me down the beach. It was so subtle, I was playing, minding my own business, but they just drug me all the way down the beach, about 200 to 300, maybe more, feet down the beach. I didn't even realize what was happening to me. You know, in life, it can be much like that. There are undercurrents in life trying to drag us off, get us off course from where we are supposed to be. I hear these comments a lot. I was raised in church. My whole life I went to church. I don't know how I got so far away from God. Spoke to a woman the other day. She was telling me how happy her marriage was until they begin to argue, until they begin to not be able to see eye to eye. She said, we were so happy at first. She said, but now we've drifted apart. We've separated. Things just aren't the same. You see, those are the results of the undercurrents that are trying to destroy our life, to get us off course. And those are the things that we need to pay attention to, because they can be so subtle, we don't even realize that they're happening. Undercurrents can be many different things. It can be hanging around with the wrong people, the wrong friends, going places and being with people that don't have the same values that you do. You know, this is what the Bible says about that. It says, bad company corrupts good character. It actually says, don't be misled. Don't be misled. Undercurrents can be bad attitudes, can be selfishness, laziness, anger. See, these are the things that can separate families. These are the things that can cause us to lose good jobs, successful careers. You see, if I would have just paid attention to where I was in relation to where that red umbrella was, I could have kept my position. See, the undercurrents were there, and they were dragging me off, because undercurrents will always have that tendency to drag us, but I could have made the necessary adjustments to get back in line. See, I could have positioned myself back to where I needed to be. I think about Samson in the Bible. Many of you know his story. The prophets predicted his birth. He was a man that had an amazing destiny lined out for him. He had this supernatural strength that God had given him. He was talented. God had positioned him in an amazing position. But he was weak in his morality. He got his eyes on the wrong things. He let his guard down. You see, he didn't keep the position that he had. Those undercurrents in life dragged him off, and he never was everything he could have been. Can you imagine if he would have just got up during the day at some point, if he would have just said to himself, am I on the right course? Am I focused? Am I aligned with my purpose? Am I treating people right? And am I respecting what God has given me? And am I walking humbly before him, honoring him with what I do? Can you imagine if he would have done that, the life he could have lived? See, he would not have had to suffer so much pain. And he wouldn't have ended up in the hands of his enemy. You see, we all need to deal with these undercurrents. See, they don't go away. Life is full of undercurrents. Life is full of distractions, temptations. You see, we all make mistakes. We all fall down sometimes, but we don't have to stay down. We can realign and readjust ourselves. We just got to be willing to ask ourselves the questions every day. Am I fulfilling my destiny? Am I honoring God? You know, it's kind of like getting off your diet and eating some ice cream. And then you go, oh, well, I'm so off my diet, I'll just go get the whole gallon. You know, we do this sometime. In fact, they say that most of life is just habits. Can I tell you, we've got to look at our habits. We've got to see if these habits are serving us, serving our family, creating the life that we were intended to have. You know, sometimes these things just seem small and insignificant. But can I tell you, it's those small things that aren't taken care of that can do damage. Throwing our words around, being disrespectful in a relationship, saying things that we want to. You see, you could say to yourself, look, I'm just letting off a little steam. They know I love them. They deserve it. They shouldn't have done that. See, we can make excuses for these little things all day long. Showing up to work late, thinking, you know, my boss isn't here. He doesn't even come till 8:30. I don't know why he expects me to be here at 8 o'clock. Surfing the internet when the company is paying you. Not being your best. See, these seem small, but these are the small things that can turn into big issues in our life if we're not careful. The scripture says it's the small foxes that spoil the vine. See, it's those things that we don't always pay attention to. They're subtle. They like to cause us to move from the position that we are supposed to be. You see, if you found yourself drifting in areas today, I want to tell you, you can refocus. You can realign yourself. It's not too late to correct. You can start today. Listen to what it says in Colossians 3:2. It says, set your mind on things above, not on earthly things. You know what that means? It means set your mind on the higher things. Set your mind on the things of value, the things of importance, the things that enrich your God-given destiny. You are full of gifts and talents. You got to set your mind on where you want to go with those gifts and talents, creating an atmosphere that brings joy and love and forgiveness. You see, just like that red umbrella marked my spot, if I would have just set my mind on it, I could have kept my position. We've got to set our mind on honoring God. Set our mind on living a life of integrity. Set our mind on fulfilling the dreams that God has put in our heart. Don't think they're too big. You've just got to set your mind on them and they'll come out of you. You know, today, let me just say this. The Bible says, lay aside those weights, those sins that so easily come against us to get us off course. Listen, God knows how easy it is You are not a failure if you have sinned. You're not a failure if you've moved out of your direction. There is no mistake that you've made today that will take you from your destiny. God loves you with an everlasting love. And he's saying it is easy. So you have to set your mind. Maybe you need to ask for forgiveness today. Maybe you need to go to a family member and say, hey, listen, I have messed up. I'm going to set my mind, set my heart on being a good husband, wife, father. Whatever it is today, you can start and begin again. I believe that you've got an amazing future in store for you. I believe that God is saying to you, I know it's easy, but I've given you the power to overcome the currents of life. You may have to wade in these currents, but you can control your life in these currents. I believe and declare today that God has a bright future in store for you, bigger than you can ever ask, think, or imagine. He's going to open new doors of opportunities for you. He's going to make up lost time for you. He's going to get you to where you need to be in Jesus' name. And if you believe that, shout a great big amen. Amen and amen.
Sometimes the difficulties of life can be so overwhelming, you feel like you're stumbling around in the dark. Things are so bad, you would need a miracle to change your situation. But is a miracle even possible?
We all face situations where we don't see a way out. It's easy to get discouraged and give up on what we're believing for. That's how we felt in 1981. My mother was diagnosed with terminal cancer and given a few weeks to live. Nothing could be done, medically speaking, but she chose to believe that God is a miracle worker. Today, 43 years later, by the grace of God, she's still healthy and strong.
I'm so grateful to be alive. I'm 90 years young. I thank God every day that he still does miracles.
I'd love to send you my new book. It's called Miracles Happen. Amen. It's filled with powerful stories of miracles from the scripture and real life stories of people that have seen the hand of God. It'll help build your faith so you can believe what seems impossible. God did it for my mother.
Yes.
He'll do it for you.
As our way of saying thank you for your gift of any amount to the ministry this month, Joel and Victoria would like to send you this powerful book, Miracles Happen, Your Journey to Supernatural Breakthrough. This new book details 30 different miracles from the Word of God, and each one comes with an encouragement and application to your own life.
Miracles still happen today, and faith is what activates God's power. When you believe, all things are possible. That's when you'll see the hand of God do supernatural things in your life.
Be sure to request your copy of Miracles Happen, Your Journey to Supernatural Breakthrough today. Visit joelosteen.com or call 888-567-JOEL.
Thank you for watching this message. We'd love to connect with you in the comments to hear your prayers and your testimonies. We thank you for supporting this ministry with your donations and your offerings. See, when you give, I believe God will open up the windows of heaven and you'll see favor in new ways for your life. I believe that your best days are still out in front of you. So make sure to like and subscribe to stay inspired all throughout the week.